Alright, time for some more, alright, time for some more Alone in the Dark, but let me take. Yep, let's get going here. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that, hopefully this time things will be a little bit smoother. Oh yeah, the only thing I know is that I have practically nothing. And the only thing I'm trying to figure out is, what's up with the clerk's office? I mean, I unlocked the safe. Is there a second puzzle? Or a third? Possibly even a fourth? Because I checked the other side and it was like, nothing here. Unless there's more. I mean, I can always come back. It's not that big of a deal. But my next destination is the stairwell. Oh no, some new items in the Grand Parlor. Agreed. Wait a minute. Either it's my overactive imagination or the parlor looks different. Oh yeah, let's go ahead and steal some money here while we're at it. Maybe mix a few drinks. Jangling Shaker. This is a secret objective, huh? Alright, I'll play. Yeah, this looks way different than from before. Looks much more refined. Gonna use the stairwell key. Actually, before I go up down, I gotta go back up and put France back on the globe. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to take a longer route. Alright, so I guess I'm gonna have to go take a longer route. That's weird. Now everything is back to normal. Huh. Weird. Oh, there's an empty room. Let's see what we got in here. Read the writing on the wall. You should come. I can't believe I didn't recognize you. Is any of this real? Number 916XXLA. It has to be a puzzle at some point. It's got to be. Give me one sec here. So it's a good thing you wrote that down. Oh, really? He's got the combination? Wait a minute. Is this what I'm thinking here? He says he's got the combination. That combination. It has to be. He says I have the combination. Where is it? Numbers. You know, I'll be back in a minute here because I can go to another room. Let's go to McCaffrey's room. I don't think Ruth's room has anything of interest. Clarity. I'm just gonna read it. Sometimes I think this place makes me worse, that Dorsetto might be my grave. A coffin made of ostentatious architecture. A Taj Mahal for the drunk and depressed. There is something about Dorsetto, something about Dr. Gray. Like we all pretend that we are here to get better, when in fact, we are here to be forgotten. Yikes. No. Okay, so I need an item for that. Okay, I have, unlike the safe, I actually have a clue that I could use. Okay, so let's see, if I were to face the door, now the treasure has to be right here. But I don't have the right item, so I will have to come back. Let's go back to that empty room. Ashes of Indigo. Interesting. Do you know? What am I looking at, though? No, that's from the clerk's office. And yet he says he has the combination, but where is it? I don't know what's going on here, but oy vey. An old coin from the time when Louisiana was a Spanish colony. For the girl.
I have made many discoveries in my case. Child is safe thanks to good people like me and you. So simple. But you don't see all the things I do.
Give us the girl, erase the dead. Wait! Oh, my wrong game.
Always been that way. Young.
Alright, before I solve that puzzle, I'm gonna... What the... I'm gonna go take a look around Ruth's room. See if there's anything of interest in here. Look at that. A shotgun shell. Oh, joy. You know, 50 would have been nicer, but... One's better than nothing, I guess. Somewhere. Or maybe perhaps I was right and there really was nothing of interest in here. Or I'll just come back later. Off to McCaffrey's room then. Oh, an interesting way of, the missing picture. Ugh. Huh, just trying to think of something here. What exactly? You don't suppose this could have been the treasure, do you? Anyways, what in the world? I'm gonna look around Ruth's room one more time. Make sure I'm not missing anything. Oh, now it's locked. Oh, that's real nice. So what's going on in the hallway now? This game is just getting more and more bizarre by the minute. Oh my god, I got... Take that! And that! Take this! And that! Take that! And this! And that! And this! Oh, now that's more like it! Now that's more like it! Four shotgun shells instead of one. Alright, get down! Come on! I get him? Come on, get down from there, you little turd. Gotcha. Got him. You hold still, you little... Ah, press B to dodge attacks. Alright, come on down. Did I get him? And I believe the bigger question is, who carries that many hatchets? I ask you, who carries that many hatchets in one box? Certainly not me. Otherwise, I better have a pretty good reason as to why I carry that many hatchets. Although, one thing I'm trying to figure out is, couldn't you just carry a hatchet in each hand and it'd be like, wah? I mean, that would work. But anyways, let's get Grace's drawing, Oh yeah, that's right, I gotta put France back on the map. That's first things first. Let's get France back on the map here. Map of the Caribbean. And two drinks. Interesting. Okay, now that we got Grace's last picture, All right, so what am I looking at? So what am I looking at? Am I? Am I trying to put the whatchamacallits together? Oh, okay, I see it now. I think I see it a little more clearly now. I gotta match the blotches to, hey, come on, get back in there. I see it now a little bit more clearly. Oh, hey, get back in there. Oh my God. Lamp in. Why does it just get more and more bizarre each minute? Okay, so I gotta go look at that lamp. That's just right outside. That is just right outside. I recognize that chair. What else in Grace's room is there? All Alright, Gracie, what else are you hiding in here? Is it Gracie or Grace? No, Grace. Anyway, I keep calling her Gracie by mistake. Alright, Gracie. Bizarre by the minute. And there is something in here that I'm missing, but maybe I can't get it right now, or maybe Emily's the only one who can get it. I don't know. Well, now look at this. What the heck? Well, I'm looking in the wrong place. What the? This is getting more bizarre by the minute. I started in Grace's room, and now I somehow end up. Come on. In Cassandra's room, of all places. This is really, really weird. Now, where am I? Writing this key. Okay. A telegram. Telegram, Western Union. My husband has returned to steal one of our most valuable paintings. Stop. I'm sure he means to sell it. Stop. If you hurry, I'm sure you can track him down. Stop. Gabriella Saunders. Newspaper clippings. A crumpled newspaper clipping from December 23rd, 1928. Philanthropist Teddy Saunders goes mad, kidnaps child. What a nut job. Oh, there's more. Photograph. I gotta figure out which case I'm currently working on. It's called Finding Jeremy. What do we have here? What the? Pay Thornville a visit? Wait a second. Am I back at this? There's gotta be. So what is this red tether tie? Let's see here. So it's here. Okay, might as well just follow the red string. Wait, where am I now? Oh. Oh, now I'm outside. following the red string. Ammo. Can't forget ammo. Now we're talking here. Let's see here. Where does it go? Can I take his bike? Come on, man. You can't go for a bike ride. Looks like the streets here are, pretty packed. Oh, what's this? Let's head inside. That is so true. There's no such thing as a clean case unless it takes less than 2 minutes to solve. Then it's considered a clean case. Lighthouse. Go to St. George's Hotel by the park and break into the kidnapper's room. Whoa, what the... back? Oh, Jesus. What was that? Oh, you. Get off. Take that. And that. Come on. Yeah? Wanna go? Come on. Oh. He's dead. Excuse me, folks. Even I get a little carried away at times. What is Sneaky gonna do? Oh, I see. I wanna wake him up. I got you now. It's funny that the flashlight doesn't wake him up, but if I make noise, it does. Where's he going? I'm surprised they're not fazed by the flashlight. Very smart. Hey, buddy, do you mind not following so closely here? Hey, personal space, buddy. Oh, all right, so that's the way you want, huh? All right, I can live by your rules. Take that, and this, and that. Whew, that was close. I really was hoping I could actually just sneak by him, but I guess that plan kind of failed. No, well. Sorry. I'm trying to think here. I wonder, is there an achievement for sneaking by an enemy? Candlestick. What good is a candlestick gonna do? In my opinion, it's probably the least effective of all weapons. That's just my take on it, though. There it is, the Hotel St. George. Oh, what's this? Uh-oh. Oh, that was a Molotov cocktail. Ah. I gotcha. I wonder if this is giving me more opportunities for this sort of thing. Now it's just... I see. It's a fire trap, so to speak. Uh-huh. I see now. That's how that achievement works. Gotcha. You know what? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go back to the last checkpoint. If I can. Hold on. Never mind. I just wish there was a checkpoint here I can go back to, because I think I see that achievement a little more clearly now. Because I think I can only kill them with throwable objects only. Yeah. Curious napkin. All the world's a stage, we're all actors. Hotel bill. A hotel bill dated December 21st through 25th, 1928. $12 for a single room, huh? Ugh. Let's get upstairs to that room. Business card. David Thornhill's business card. Okay, so it looks like there's a couple of items here I'm still missing. Telephone directory. DeWitt Boarding School. Wait, Booker DeWitt? Alright. Oh, well, now where am I? Am I in the bayou? Pearl River. so many paths to take, and yet only one leads the right way. The others will lead me astray. Propane totem. Profane. Ooh, what's this? Edward had heard the whispers for years. When he lived in Brooklyn, it was only on rare occasions. Like when he as a child climbed that tall tree in Central Park, or when he almost drowned in the Hudson River, trying to save his spare mother. The whispers became more common as he moved to New Orleans, but still rare enough to be ignored. Now as he walks the halls of Derceto, he knows what is calling him. He doesn't want to admit it, but the dark young in the conservatory is telling him to sacrifice the Cabri Sant Corn. Let's go take a look at the objectives. Ah, geez. Where did you come from? Get off of me. Oof. Jesus. Here. Oh, another candlestick. Oh, it's just loops. All along. What the?
Being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What's this for?
Mission of guilt. Maybe acceptance. That's what the dark man wants.
I guess we just watched my father die. I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. He will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him.
We? Do it yourself. I'm down there with him, remember?
This is getting more bizarre by the minute. What's even more puzzling is that if she's down there, why is she sitting on the bridge? Is there more to this story than what I'm looking at right now? Well, don't answer that. I want to discover this for myself. What in the... What the... Oh, this! Oh, this is gonna be good. This is gonna be real good. Gotta make my way back. Get off, you little twerps. Oof. Once again, I see more boxes of hatchets. Can't get over that. Get off me, you little buggers. Oof. More of them? Get off. Find the bullet. Wherever it is. I have to go by the house to the sinking car. Okay, I saw the... Okay, ironic, I saw the boat earlier, but... I was trying to figure out exactly how to get back. Unless I'm on the wrong side. Yeah, I'm on the wrong side. Aha! Uh-huh. There is another one of those little buggers. Yeah, there's the boat. It's right there. Here we go. What was your first clue? Thank you. Alright, what next? The infirmary is next. You know? I wonder if I can go back up to the attic. I guess I could go back downstairs. Actually, no, I have to go downstairs now. Since I got the stairwell opened. By the way, one thing I just realized, what was that secret objective? Edward had heard the whispers for years. Oh, wait. Never mind, I already read that. Memory. Here we are. Scapegoat. Unspeakable cults. Dorsetto stands on a breeding ground for the grotesque, a temple devoted to rebellious growth, the most ugly and cancerous side of nature. You may be able to shield your psyche for a while, but rest assured your soul will come to pray to that hideous god in time. That is the story of every man and woman who gather around that ancient arbor. They all croak, bark, and bleed. Because their own bodies are afraid, and they wish to repel the evil those words conjure. However you pronounce that. Yeah. Instead of that blasphemous name, they gossip in hushed whispers the names of Dorsetto, Astarte, and the Black Goat of the Woods. Weird. Well, anyways, we gotta go to the infirmary now. Okay, so I don't have the key for the infirmary. Radiograph number one. Partial capture of a brain ground by unsettling darkness. Radiography notes. Patient Jeremy Harwood, date June 14th, 1930. Jeremy's skull proved difficult to capture properly. Partial radiographs work best. A complete picture of the brain can be assembled by piecing three plates together. Even when looking at an assembled version, a shadow covers significant parts of Jeremy's brain. Possible tumor, but more likely that the equipment is failing. Jeremy reacted strongly to the pictures and claimed to see a giant clay worm eating and displacing his memories. While this exercise has left me nowhere closer to an answer, I feel confident that a Burkhardt lobotomy should sever all necessary parts. All else fails. Hypothetical psychosurgery based on the ideas of Burkhardt and the St. Petersburg research could end up saving Jeremy's life. Severing the connections around the frontal lobe would certainly solve most mental afflictions. The procedure would be brutal in performance as well as in efficiency. An ice pick pushed through the edge of the eye and into the skull would untether the nerves like Alexander cutting the Gordian knot. As this would likely leave Jeremy in a very different condition, all other paths should first be explored. The medical instrument I would feel for this lobotomy is missing and I should have what? Order a new one. This is a little unsettling. Actually, I don't even want to think about, the whole procedure. Ugh. Alright, here's radiograph number 2. And there's the surgery room key. Then we got a fuse. Alright, there's more we're gonna need. But we can open up the infirmary. Another fuse. Very nice. Oh, I see how it works. And there's part number 3. That's not right. Oh, right. There's something on that one. This has to be the correct bottom. That's okay, let's put the rest of these pieces back. No, I don't think that's right. Doesn't look right either. That certainly doesn't look right either. In fact, I think I was closer the first time. Something like this. What piece am I missing? Well, there isn't much room. Unless... Well, like I said, the bottom piece is right. This is correct because you don't place an excerpt with a note on the top. Unless it does go like this, heck if I know. This is too big. That looks wrong too. There we go. Ooh, that's lovely. Jeremy's Darkness, key item. Missing some items. That was just blocked. So what am I missing in here? Shouldn't be missing anything. Oh boy, now I get to go on a scavenger hunt for pieces of a statue. Oh joy. This is going to be incredibly tedious. What the? Guess you gotta go up in the world. Wait, I built it back already? That was quick. There's gotta be a clue in here somewhere. Tessellated shard. Thank you. more snooping around. Oh, that's all that was. Huh. Just open up something and you get absolutely nothing out of it. Go figure. I hate it when games do that. Anyways, let's get back up to that attic. Open up Jeremy's mind. What's left of it. Just trying to think here. Trying to figure out what I'm doing wrong. It says, oh, I guess the room's done. Okay. Nice taxidermy. Mr. Falcon. Wait a minute, what's this? Oh, this is the, oh. Okay, so there are numbers here. Perfect. Perfect. Let's see here. 149. This could be... Interesting. So a noose and a circular window. This is just getting weirder by the minute. There it is. It's right here. So now what? Nope, can't go out that way. And I sure as heck am not going to use that noose on myself. No thanks. I don't know where I'm at.
Hello? Is anyone there? I need help! Wait. I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking me. The motor is dead.
Get off me, you little twerp. Oof. That was close. To the engine room below deck. Jesus, a little twerp. Where'd he go? There you are. Got him. All right. Oh, great. More of these little buggers. I guess that wasn't it. Jesus! How did that happen? Oh, it didn't, because it was just being stupid. Oh my god. Leave an offering at the Whispering Tree. Okay. Don't... Jesus Christ, I didn't tell you to go down. Okay, that's more like it. So now I gotta leave an offering at the Whispering Tree. I think one of these little buggers here and put them at the Whispering Tree. Oh, for God's sakes. Now what? Jesus alive. What is the problem? Buggers. All the other enemies are easy to deal with. These are just little buggers. There. You did. Okay, so there is a way up there. So we figure out how to get in, though. Helen Mask. The Pirates of Pontchartrain. The artist spent a lot of time boating on the vast lake Pontchartrain. Poetry, painting, photography, everything seemed to become better by the shimmering water and the opalescent sky. One night as the sailors returned to Dorsetto, they found a masquerade ball taking place. It must have been Perosi Dorsetto. They found him. Percy and Nora, who invited their friends from the theater. The sailors quickly fashioned masks out of plaster of Paris and joined the festivities. They enjoyed themselves for hours before realizing time was not passing, nor could they find their friends. As they began to worry, they demanded that the guests unmask, but they could not because they were not wearing any. Weird. Where is this whispering tree? I gotta make an offering to. Oh, here we go. Right in the face. Thank you.
40 years ago, Frederick needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Find your focus.
Hey, I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Everything is wrong. Nothing is in play.
I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Khan. What do you want?
Are you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
Oof. You know, I think this is a good place to stop for right now. Alright, I think that's going to do it for this session. Thank you to those who watch. I'll see you all next time.